since we only have one obstacle in here, I'm gonna give you tell him to, you're gonna stand on the mounting block and you're gonna tell him to back away from you. You're gonna tell him to make one circle this way. You're gonna tell him to stop. You can turn him around and make him do another circle the other way. Let me show you?
Yeah.
Okay, so get out of my circle zone. So, you stand on the lower step. I'm gonna ask him to back away from me. Then when he gets to about Kazi's tail, I'm gonna jack him and talk to his tail. Tell him to stop. Then I'm gonna tell him to go that way. Okay, so that's what I want you to do. When I get back over here, when I start to see his nose come in front of the gate, I'm gonna bump his nose, look at his tail, stop him, keep him out there. Then I'm gonna invite him in. Pet him. I'm going to turn around. I'm going to even give you this. You're going to turn around, you're going to step up here, and you're going to tell him to come get in front of the mounting block. Stop him.
Okay.
Back him up. Back. Back. Over a tiny bit. Not forward. Back. Back. Over. This way. Over. Hunter. Over. Good job.
Now he's waiting for someone to get on his back.
Good. Okay. Good job. Good job. Come on. Hope. And then take one more time before you get on. Go ahead and do that. Here he is. Come on. Giddy up.
Now I will get on the mountain block.
Yep. Hope. You're going to get on the lower step. You're gonna get on the lower step. You're gonna back him away from you. So you can bring him if you want, because you're gonna back him away anyway. Okay, now, yep, back him away.
Back.
Okay, now go easy unless he's not backing up. Good, good, tell him to back though. Now he's not listening again, so now
back.
You can get loud.
Back, back.
Good. And then you go quiet again if he starts moving, right? So see, he stopped again, so.
Back.
Yep, don't stop talking to him.
Back.
Mean it, mean it.
Back.
Good. Now rest. Wait till he asks you a question, which is both ears pointed at you. Good. Now tell him what to do. How do you tell him to move?
Oh, okay.
Good. Now, pass the rope around behind you. Don't follow him with your eyes. Kiss. Just to make sure he stays going. Good. When he gets to about Cosmo's jacket there, bump his nose. Look at his tail. Look at his tail.
Oh.
You've forgotten that part.
Oh. Oh.
Okay. So now, don't be so quick to yank on him. We want to bump his nose. That's different from grabbing and yanking on him, right? You want to give him a little bump. You want to say, hey, listen, right? That's a lot nicer than what you just did, right? Go ahead and back him away.
Back. Back.
Back.
Back.
Back. Back. Yep, so keep it going. Don't stop. Don't stop and look anywhere else. Just keep you going. Back. Back.
Back.
Back. Doesn't drift out of your hand. Back. Back. So when he does that, then he goes, back. Back. And then you go back to ask him. Back. Right? Good. Now he's asking a question. Don't let him go the way he just asked. Tell okay. That's the way he asked to go. I would have told him to go the other way. Never let him decide. If he says, can we go that way, say, well, actually I wasn't planning on it. So when his nose gets to the gate, you're going to give him a friendly bump on the nose just to tell him you're going to tell him to do something. Then you're going to look at his tail. Friendly bump. Friendly bump. Look at his tail. Watch what a friendly bump looks like. Okay, tell him this way. You have a friendly bump, and look at his tail. Okay? So we're not going to yank on him. We're not going to not get any energy there either. So you got to go somewhere in between. Okay, before you were too rough, and this time you couldn't talk to him. So you want to make sure that you try to make that snap move, just to say something to him, but you don't want to be yanking on him. Okay? And then you're going to look at his tail. You can't forget to look at his tail. Otherwise, he's going to come all the way over to you and go, yeah, what do you want? Right? So we don't want him to do that. We want him to stay out there and stand there and go, yes, ma'am, what do you want? Right? Okay, try that. Point where you want him to go. He doesn't know where you want him to go. Gets by Cosmo's jacket, bump his nose. Look at his tail, look at his tail, look at his tail. Nope. So, when you bump his nose in that case, he just kept on walking. Okay, go ahead, when he gets by Cosmo's jacket, bump his nose, look at his tail. Bump his nose, look at his tail. So, you're getting to bump his nose now. You went from being too rough to not doing it at all. Okay? No, we can't use Cosmo's jacket. Where it was. Do you remember where it was? Okay, so go ahead and send him around towards me. Okay, now you're going to bump his nose with this hand. You're going to take this hand and go like this. Okay, so you've got to not have him listen, but he's not listening. Okay, so the hand that you want to use when you bump his nose is the hand that's going... Tell him to go. Tell him to go. You just sit there and watch him. You gotta tell him to do stuff. Now, yep. With the other hand, you should have bumped his nose. The other hand, but he just went over. There. Well, he did it at the end, but he did it right at you, right? So we don't want him to do it right at you. We want him to do it out there on the end. So your hands were in the wrong position, right? Okay, let's try again. Good. Now you're just looking at him.
How would I make him go farther out?
Kiss. Yep, till he does what you want. So he's not doing what you want. You gotta keep doing it and then give him a little, yep. So you don't quit on him, because if you quit on him, he knows eventually you will quit. That's better, but we want to make sure now it's out further away. Okay, so let's get him out further on the line. Just a whole long time ago. Okay, so we're going to back him away. Go ahead and get him back away.
Back.
Don't just say it the main time. Back.
Back.
Back. You know, when he falls out, say back.
Back. Back.
There. Now, send him one way or the other. Good. There you go. You went the wrong way with the rope. Way you were fanning it. When he gets his nose to the gate, you're going to change hands, you're going to bump his nose. Change hands, bump his nose. That's better. It's getting getting better, but he's coming into you. So how would you stop him from coming into you if you don't want him to come all the way? No. Yeah, yeah. So when his feet turn and face you and then they start coming this way, say, no, 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 don't come in here, right? You don't want to get real like, don't come in here. You just want to say, no, 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 don't come in here. So you're going to give him enough wiggle to say don't. Okay? Let's try again.
Back.
Now you would say back again, right? Because he stalled
back.
Out.
Back.
There you go. And you want to get as quiet as you can if he keeps going. Now,
back.
Yep, he stopped. So, yep, tell him you're not done yet.
Back.
Good. Tell him which way you want him to go. Good. Kiss. Make him get going. Pay attention to the length of your rope so he doesn't step on it. Good. And how would you bump his nose?
Aww.
So what might be wrong right there, though? And then he did it anyway, and then what did you do?
And then I just left.
Right. So he kind of didn't do the right thing, and then we just told him he was such a good boy for that. Right? So it's not that we don't want to love on him, but we don't want to love him on him at the wrong time. Because if we love on him now, he thinks he did the right thing. So now, next time, he's definitely going to come in here.
Back. Back.
Stand on the mounting block more because it seems like you have to get authoritative there. Yep. Yep. Other way with the rope. See? He felt that and now you're petting him again. So he doesn't have to do anything. He's just going to come see you and you're just going to give him some love. Send him away. So that rope helps send him away. See? Flip it the other way though. No, see, that's what's happening. Yeah, easy. So that's what's happening. Okay? You're actually, you watch what you just did? So what you actually did was you did all this. You collected all their line. You brought him to you. He's not supposed to come to you. You're supposed to keep him just as far away as you can. Out. Okay? And then see what's happening is after he comes around behind you, you start getting ready to tell him to turn around, but you go pulling them all in. You start reeling them in. So he has absolutely no choice but to come here. So you're telling him to do that. So we can't get mad at him. So you actually did tell him to do that. So back, 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 back. So we want him to stay out there. And then we want to bump in and look at his tail thing.
Oh.
And we want him to stay there. So if he thinks he's coming, I say, no, 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 that's not what I want.
Okay.
You think you can do that?
Hope.
Good job. Good job. Now, keep him out there. Don't gather all that rope. Don't reel him in. Huh? Tell him to keep going. Tell him to keep going. So now you can turn and talk to him because he's turned around and talk. Oh, now he's just going to go wherever he wants. So what's wrong with that, though? Think about it. As his boss, what's wrong right now? So go ahead and bump his nose. Look at his tail. Keep him out there. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Bump his nose. Look at his tail. You're looking at his nose. Bump him away. Wiggle him away. Okay. Now just let him move neutral. So, what is wrong with what just happened?
I said that.
No. When he started going the other way, what was wrong with that? Right. He made a decision and you let him do it. So he took over. He's the boss. Okay? As much as that was very nice and he did what you wanted him to do after you agreed to do it that way, but he should be agreeing with you, not you agreeing with him. Okay? So you should have stopped him and said, no, no, that's not the way I want to go. Instead of letting him go and then you say, oh, okay, I guess we're going to go this way. Okay? Because that was his decision. It can't be his decision. Right? But that was nice at the end there. Okay. So we'll go ahead and we'll call that done. But never let him tell you what you're going to do. Okay? Because you start letting him do that, he's going to walk all over you. He's going to start doing everything he wants to do and not anything you want to do. And that's not a good partnership. Bump him so he knows to stop going there. So you didn't bump him, did you? Now what would you do next? Careful, other guy. What would you do next?
Yeah.
Easy now. Don't start off real mean. Ask nice. If he doesn't respond, then you get mean.
Back.
Now he's not even just doing his own thing again, and you're just watching him do it. Yep. So now you're facing him. That's why he's coming sideways, because you're facing him. So you want to face me, right? Face me. Bring the rope around in front of you. Yep. Thank you. why do you have the ring closest to you shorter? In case he was to be bad and move off, you would have an ability to push his tail away from you instead of pulling him on top of you. Pull on this ring, right? When he gets bad, he will spin his tail away, right? Going like this means you're pulling on him, right? Okay. So how are you going to ask him to go forward? Yep. And? Good. Steer him off of me. Okay, so today we're going to practice posting. Yep, you have to steer him too. It's coming over to me. There you go. Now put some weight towards your heels there. Don't want your toes sticking down. There you go. So, steer him away from me. There you go. Okay. Practice posting. Now what I taught your brother today is what we post to. We post to that outside leg. It's called your diagonal. Okay? So when that outside leg moves forward, can you tell it's moving forward?
Yeah.
Okay. When that outside leg moves forward, you're going to be up out of the saddle. Hunter?
Easy.
Hunter?
Easy.
Yep. Good. So you got to do a little faster because he's going pretty fast, isn't he? So you're coming up with the inside leg, and you're steering him not. Careful, now it's not his fault you're not steering him, so don't yank on him, right? You've kind of grabbed a hold of his face real quick there. It's not his fault you aren't steering. Yep, 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 there you go, there you go.
Easy.
Walk.
Easy.
So you're coming up with the inside leg. Okay, go up the outside leg. Up. Up. But see, what's happening is, I don't know if you noticed, but your legs keep flipping back and they're kicking them in the side every time you do that. So you don't want to do that, because that's what's making them mad. So you don't want it to be about kicking our legs back. There you go. Much better. Much better. Hunter? Good. Hunter? So come out of the saddle, though. There you go. There you go. Yep. Yep. There you go. Yep. So, did you want to try to trot?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so, we're not going to kiss because he's going to trot anyway. If you ask him to trot with a kiss, he's going to go really fast. So, we're going to make sure our reins are short enough that if we need to tell him to easier, we need to tell him to stop. We can. Okay? So now, we're going to just... We didn't tell him to do that yet. Okay, so are you accidentally kicking him, you think? Try to put weight on the ball of your foot there. Put some weight, push your heels down towards the ground. Okay, yep. You don't have to stick them all out. Can you keep them there and do that? Okay. That's going to go forward. Or pull. Okay. Good. So now, he's not going to need you to kick. He's not going to need you to squeeze. He's just going to need you to put your reins forward. So Lightly, yep, and then raise yourself. Try to post Careful you don't squeeze him by accident. You're ready, not before. Don't take it if he doesn't. So that would be walk. I would tell him to walk right. If you didn't ask him to do that, tell him to walk. Hunter! Your legs are in his sides. Wow. Okay? So we're going to have to work it out of walk for a little while, okay? Because you're a little wild up there, and it's making him upset, and your leg was way back here in his side, right? So we don't want to make him mad. We want to be as balanced as we can. So we're going to practice it at the walk a little bit more. Okay? So go ahead and ask him to go out there. Now he's all excited. So go ahead and turn towards me and we'll change directions. Turn him, give him rein, give him the other rein. You're pulling on both. Good.
Easy.
Stop. He doesn't want me to get on. Go ahead and steer him out away from me. Not too much. Now you remember you're making it, you're being kind of like, turn. Okay? We want to be like, hey, walk this way. You know, you want to be polite about it. He doesn't know that you want to turn him. Just because I told you doesn't mean he heard me or understood me. Yeah, that's nice. Hunter?
Easy.
Good. Steer him though. Hunter.
Easy.
Good. Hunter. Certainly a lot to do. If you're in trouble and you gotta figure out where your reins are, then that's too much. You're supposed to be so automatic. Nope. So we got a lot of practice on that now. Yep, yep. And bring them around to your toe. See, look at this. Okay? That tells him to go. We don't want to put our leg into him like that, okay? You can't push your leg into him because he's gonna respond. You have to have your legs off of him. You can't put your heel into the side of him. Okay, so pay attention to what your legs are doing. How do you emergency stop? Yep, yep, yep. Good, good. Well, still walking. Yep, yep. Keep the other rein loose enough that he can do that, okay? So, ready? You're gonna go like this. down that rein and pull and give, let go of the rest of that. Like, let that go loose. Well, not all the way to the ground. Like, let the tension out. Okay? So, when you go to grab away, you're just going to kind of let your hand go loose so he can come all the way around. Because if you hold him from being able to, so go ahead, try again. Yep. Yep. There. Now hold the reins, but just let them go through your hand. Yep. Yep. Pull his head around all the way. Get your leg off his side. Yep. Pull his head around. Pull his head around. Pull his head around. Pull it around. Pull it around. Pull it around. Pull it around. All the way, like you're trying to get his nose on your foot. And if your foot's way back there, that's not fair. There you go. So you can pull his head around. Okay? Okay? That's what I want to see him do. Because he's being bad enough that we can practice that. Okay? Because he's being bad. He's being bad because your legs are sticking into his sides. So go ahead. We're going to go ahead and tighten it. I mean, go ahead and do an emergency stop. Yep. 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 Pull him all the way around to your toe. Pull him all the way around to your toe. Pull him all the way around to your toe. There. Good. Okay? I want you to practice that a few times because I can't let him off the line until you can stop him. And if he starts acting like he's acting, we want to make sure we can stop him because he's taking charge. He's the boss right now, and we got to make sure he doesn't think so. Okay, so go ahead, and we're going to ask him to walk, and then I'm going to tell you to do emergency stop. And I want you to not quit until his nose is near your toe. And if your toe is all the way back by his tail, that's not fair because that means you're kicking him at the same time. Okay? Emergency stop. Don't quit till he's to your toe. Don't quit till he's to your toe. Don't quit till he's to your toe. Excellent. Now let him go. Okay? We're going to do that a couple times, all right? I need to make sure you feel good about being able to stop him. Okay? We're not going to let him loose today anyway. He's being too bad. Okay? But I want to make sure you can do that. The day I let you loose, he's probably going to know it. And if he's going to be bad or you let him get away with doing other stuff, see, you're letting him walk. You told him to walk. Okay, so you gotta be the boss. You gotta be paying attention to him and me. Okay, ask him to go forward. Okay, he went by himself. Tell him to go away from me.